I've waited for 3 years now to redo this whole closet and have bins that are similar and more in unison. I took everything out, regrouped everything, and went ahead and separated things by categories, and then I dedicated one bin per category, so it worked out really nice. The original orange bins, which they actually sell in white also, are from the Dollar Tree, but I wasn't able to find white ones to redo this whole project using just white ones, so I ended up buying these other ones from Target. So I actually bought these bins for the garage because I absolutely loved how pretty but yet durable they are. And so I ended up running upstairs and seeing if they fit in this closet, and they ended up fitting, so I knew this was a project that I wanted to tackle using some of those garage bins. As I mentioned before in our previous decluttering and organizing videos, it's always a matter of playing Tetris. You have to figure out where the bins fit, how you can maximize the space, and so I basically had to mess with them a few times just to see if I can use the bigger bins versus the regular size bins, and how to even use the two different colored ones, because I bought gray ones and then I also had to buy these lighter blue ones since they ran out of the gray ones. So right below the towels are the two bigger bins that I decided to flip facing each other. Using bigger containers like these allow for bigger items, so this was perfect for the linens. So both of those are dedicated to bed sheets for the kids' room, our room, and the baby room. So all of them fit on one shelf, which worked out nicely because before it felt like it was just a hodgepodge mess. And all the linen sheets that I'm placing in that back container are the things that I'll be donating or throwing out, depending on if they're stained or in good condition. I'm not sure if any of you have this issue, but ideally I'd like to keep two sets per bed. That way one set stays on the bed and the other one is just there for backup in case of an accident or a spill or anything like that. But the issue that I'm having is I have a hodgepodge of a bunch of different things that are mismatched. So ideally in the long run, I'd love to have them all match and just have two of the same ones. So it makes it so much harder to narrow it down when I don't actually have full sets that match. And I'm not sure if you caught that, but I used a hot pink gift bag to separate the crib from the older girls' beds. Now this bin is all related to potty training. I have tons and tons of pads for when I start potty training, which will be any day now. They're perfect to use when you don't want your little one to have an accident on a couch. I struggled with some of the bins because there were miscellaneous things in them, but this one is all for traveling. I don't think I ever realized how much space is wasted from using round bins instead of square or rectangular bins. Because originally my things barely fit in the round bin and now they actually fit perfectly, I do want to regroup them and make sure that everybody has a travel bag for when we do leave. I also like to separate the shampoos from conditioner, from body washes and lotions. That way we just grab them as needed when we are actually packing for an upcoming trip. Once I separated them, I actually decided to toss everything left in the big clear bag because I simply had too many and I knew that I wouldn't use them. Some might even be expired. That's why I really needed to get rid of some of them. And if you're anything like me, you've noticed that every single time you stay at a hotel, you constantly grab the leftover shampoo and conditioner and bring them back home. So a lot has accumulated over the years, and I've already thrown a bunch out a while back, but apparently I still had way more to go. This one is for steaming clothes, and honestly I felt like I had to think out of the box on how to categorize them, so I think I need to do a second sweep for sure. I have not gotten around to doing a second sweep of this linen closet, and the reason I'm mentioning it is because I've noticed that it's the second sweep that makes the area a lot more functional and manageable, and so I'm not head over heels for the way I separated the categories, but it works for now. I definitely think I need to do a second sweep and kind of just regroup them, and more importantly actually label them so everybody in the household knows what bin is for what category. So all the way at the top I try to keep three bins that I don't use as often, which are my highlighting stuff, waxing things, and things related to travel. And so those are the three bins that typically the kids don't even have to reach, so I like having those at the top. Well, this goes to show how often I use these bins. There was a bin that had these light bulbs that we don't even have in this house. It's from our old house and we've been living here for 3 years. So in terms of towels, I was contemplating leaving these towels just out and not using the bins, but I actually just like how it makes them look more unison. And these are the towels that we typically use more for guests, and I'm one of the people that uses these white towels. Otherwise, each person in the house has one color towel and that's pretty much their go-to towel. So I wanted to show you what I mean by using these circular bins. Notice if it's much better in this square bin versus the round one. It kind of created that box look around it and it messed up the bristles on the brushes for highlighting kit. And a lot of the items actually just fit a lot better and it gave me a lot more space in each bin versus the round one. Since they get smaller at the bottom, it just doesn't allow for a lot of things to fit in there. So if it's a tighter space, definitely go for rectangular or square bins. You'll maximize your vertical space and it'll help so much. So here are the results, I absolutely love how it turned out. And more importantly, I love that it's okay for the door to be opened when we walk up the hall. Before, when the door stayed open, it would just kind of be overwhelming to even see all the clutter in there. Here are some of the other things that we got rid of that I completely forgot to add a few weeks back when our floors were being redone. You would also think by now that I'd be used to decluttering, but yet I really struggled to get rid of this easel. I think because I feel like the concept of having it is nice, but the kids didn't use it much and they were totally fine with getting rid of it. I also got rid of two of these desks. That's because my older ones were the only ones that had them, and so I'd like to have the same type of desk for all four kids in the long run. This is my miscellaneous pile that I just collected over the week of things that I would toss or donate. You may already know this, but I've gone through a lot of the cosmetics around the house to see how toxic they are, and I'm getting rid of all these things that you see. In the meantime, I've done hours and hours of research of makeup and cosmetics that are actually really good for our skin, and so these are the three that are actually not toxic and have a good score on the app that I have been using to figure out which ones I should replace and which ones I can continue to actually use without being concerned of harmful ingredients. And I saved my best find for last. This is the bouquet I had at my wedding. It was obviously a lot more beautiful with white flowers instead of these darkish brownish flower. And the other bouquet is the bouquet I held up at my sister-in-law's wedding. So these are definitely ones to toss, but it was a sweet memory to share with the kids and were totally worth keeping for over 12 years now. And here's the total so far. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. It really supports us. And I will see you guys next time as I dive into the schoolroom. And when I say schoolroom, I mean things including arts, crafts, games, and so much more.